Hello students, welcome to my next video. Today we will understand exploratory research design in my session. I, Dr. Rondevale, welcome you all in Business Research Methods online lecture series. Don't forget to like and subscribe. This is lecture number 11, exploratory research. Learning questions for today's session. What is the concept of exploratory research design? What are the steps to conduct an exploratory research design? What are the exploratory research design approaches, and what are various characteristics including pros and cons of exploratory research? So we will start with exploratory research design. Exploratory research is a systematic investigation carried out for a problem that has not been studied more clearly previously and establishes priorities, develop operational definitions, and improve the final research design. Exploratory research helps to determine the best research design, suitable data collection methods, and selection of objects. It should draw definite conclusions only with extreme cautions. It gives its fundamental nature. The exploratory research often concludes that a perceived problem does not actually exist. Moving on, exploratory research is defined as a research used to investigate a problem which is not clearly defined. That's why it is called as exploratory. It is concluded that to have a better understanding of the existing problem, but will not provide the conclusive results. So we will learn more about exploratory research design. An important aspect here is that researcher should be willing to change his or her direction subject to the relevance of the new data or insights. Such a result is usually carried out when the problem is at preliminary stage. It is often referred to as the grounded theory approach or interpretive research, as it used to answer questions like what, why, and how. An exploratory research design is conducted about a research problem when there are few or no earlier studies are or referred to. The focus is on ongoing insights and familiarities for the latter investigation undertaken when problems are in preliminary stage of the investigation. Now we will understand various steps to conduct an exploratory research. There are three steps. One is to identify the problem. The researcher identifies the subject of research and the problem is addressed by carrying out multiple methods to answer the questions. Then second step is creating the hypothesis. When the researcher has found out there are no prior studies and the problem is not precisely resolved, the researcher will create a hypothesis based on the questions obtained while identifying the problem. Then further research. This is step number three. Once the data has been obtained, the researcher will continue his study or her study through the descriptive investigation. Qualitative methods are used to found further study the subject in detail and find out if the information was true or not. So these are various steps. Now we will see various approaches. So the exploratory research approach can be divided into two parts. First is primary research approach and second is secondary research approach. So in the figure, the right hand side, you can see the secondary research approaches. These approaches includes online research, literature research, and case study research. And in left side, in the blue diagram, you can see primary research approaches of exploratory research. And those research approaches are surveys or polls, then interview methods, focus groups, and observation. So there are 4 + 3, that those are total 7 approaches. Now we will understand each and every approach one by one. We will start with the exploratory research. primary research approaches. So there are experience surveys or polls, in-depth interview, focus group, observations, and projective techniques. So using these five techniques, exploratory research approach using the primary research can be conducted. Now we will understand each and every approach in detail. First, we will start with experience surveys or polls. An experience survey is a set of questions designed to gauge the overall satisfaction of a group of people who have shared a common experience. Businesses commonly distribute these surveys among the customers, and educational institutes often distribute among the students. Experience surveys usually compose of two types of questions. The first are multiple choice of questions that allows participants taking the survey to rate their experiences on a scale like Likert scale or to indicate their satisfaction levels by choosing from the list of responses. Many experience surveys also include open-ended questions in which individuals write short responses or opinion about a particular question or phenomenon. So this is how experience surveys or polls can be conducted. Next part is in-depth interview. It's important to start with a good literature research, but at some point it is desirable to talk to a person who is said to be expert in that particular field and persons who are well informed in the area that being investigated. Here we don't need questioner. These people could be professionals or persons outside of the organizations. The approach adopted should be highly unstructured so that the participants can give the divergent views. In-depth interviews are widely used to tap the knowledge and experience of the individuals with information which is strongly related to the situation. So this is about in-depth interview. Now we will start with the next part, which is focus group. A focus group is a small but demographically diverse group of people whose reactions are studied especially in the market research or political analysis, in guided or open discussions about a new product or something else to determine the reaction that can be expected from the larger population. It is a form of qualitative research consisting of the interviews in which a group of people are asked about their opinions, their perceptions, beliefs, and attitude towards a particular product, service, concept, advertisement, idea, packaging, etc. The questions are asked in interactive group setting where participants are free to talk with the other group members. During this process, the researcher either takes notes or records the vital points he or she is getting from the group. Researchers should select members of the focus group carefully for the effective and authoritative responses. So this is about focus group and how you can conduct a focus group. Next is important, that is observation method. Observation is a systematic data collection approach. Researchers use all their senses to examine the people in a natural setting or naturally occurring situations. Observation research, sometimes called as field research, is a type of correlational, that is non-experimental research, in which researcher observes the ongoing behavior. It is a social research technique that includes the direct observation of phenomenon in their natural settings. Observations can provide the foundation of the theories and hypothesis development. Next technique is projective techniques. Projective techniques are indirect and unstructured methods of investigation, which have been developed by the psychologist and use projection of the respondents for inferring about their underlying motives, urge, or intentions, which cannot be secured through the direct questions as the respondents either resist to reveal them or unable to figure out themselves. These techniques are useful in giving respondents the opportunity to express their attitudes or perceptions or beliefs, etc., without personal embarrassment. These techniques help the respondents to project their own attitude and feelings unconsciously on the subject under study. So these are various projective techniques. Now we will move towards next approach, that is exploratory research using secondary approach. Up till now we have seen five approaches, that is primary research approaches. Now we will see secondary research approaches. Secondary research approaches can be subdivided into three parts: online research, literature research, and case study research. Now we will see each and every method one by one. So online research, literature research, and case study research. Yes. So we will start with online research. In today's world, this is one of the fastest way to gather the information of any topic. A lot of data is readily available on the internet, and a researcher can download it wherever he or she needs it. An important aspect to be noted for such type of research is the genuineness and authenticity of the sources, website, and the researcher is gathering the information from. So online research conduction is that way fastest in today's world. The next is literature research. Literature research is one of the most expensive method used for discovering a hypothesis. There is tremendous amount of information available in the libraries and online sources, even on commercial databases. Sources can include newspapers, magazines, books from libraries, documents from government agencies, specific topics related to articles, annual reports, literature reports, and published statistical from the research organizations or government organizations, authentic organizations, and so on. So this is how you can conduct literature research. Third approach is case study research. Case study research can help researcher for finding out more information through carefully analyzing existing studies and cases which have gone through a similar problem. Such analysis is very important and critical, especially in today's business world. The researcher just needs to make sure that he analyzes the case study carefully regards to all the variables present in the previous case against his own case. It is very commonly used in business organizations or social sciences sectors or even in health sector. So this is about case study approach. Now we will understand the importance of exploratory research. Exploratory research is carried out when a topic needs to be understood in depth, especially if it hasn't been done before. The goal of such research is to explore the problem and around it and not actually derive a conclusion from it. Such kind of research will enable a researcher to set a strong foundation for exploring his ideas, choosing the right research design, and finding the variables that actually are important for the analysis. Most importantly, such research can help organizations or researcher to save a lot of time and resources, as it will enable the researcher to know if it is worth pursuing. So this is the importance of exploratory research. Now we will understand the characteristics of exploratory research. They are not structured studies, which are usually low cost, interactive, and open-ended. To carry out the exploratory research, generally, there is no prior research done, or the existing ones do not answer the problem precisely enough. It's a time-consuming research and needs to patience and has risk associated with it. That risk is maybe you will not get any findings or proper findings. There are no set of rules to carry out the exploratory research as per. They are very flexible, broad, and scattered. It will enable a research to answer some questions like what is the problem, what is the purpose of the study, and what topics could be studied here. And the last characteristics, the researcher will have to go through all the information available for a particular study if the researcher is doing. So these are various characteristics of exploratory research. Now we will understand pros, that is advantages of exploratory research. Exploratory research are usually low cost, considerable flexibility to the researcher, a built foundation for the research process. Errors, if any, can be detected very early, and it builds foundation study for the further research and other researchers. So these are various advantages of exploratory research. Now we will see various cons, that is disadvantages of exploratory research. Through early detection of errors in research, it is usually inconclusive. Then they provide qualitative data whose data interpretation can be judgmental or biased. Mostly for smaller sample size, thus cannot be generalized. And for secondary research approaches, data may be not updated or it may be older data. So these are various disadvantages of exploratory research. So today we have learned a lot of things. What we have learned, we have understood the concept of exploratory research design. We have seen three steps how to conduct exploratory research. We have seen primary approaches and secondary approaches of exploratory research design. We understood various characteristics, advantages, disadvantages, pros and cons of exploratory research design. We have learned that. So what is next? In my next video, we will understand the next approach or type of research design, that is descriptive research design. Till then, keep thinking, keep learning. Like, share, subscribe, comment, and turn on bell icon for further notification. All the best for your studies. These are some references that I have used for my preparing this PPT. Thank you so much.